Volkswagen Tanok is an Atlas-based pickup truck concept. For a concept designed to test the waters, the Atlas Tanok looks surprisingly production-ready. Ditch the LED grille and winch-equipped front bumper, slap on a new tailgate and rear bumper, and then put in production spec leather, and the Tanok is ready to go. All I'm saying is that automakers don't slap on windshield wipers or invest in expensive bumper cut lines if they aren't at least seriously considering putting it in production. As the name suggests, the Tanok is based on the Volkswagen Atlas, but with a total length of 214.1 inches, it's nearly 16 inches longer. The wheelbase has also been stretched by 11 inches to accommodate a 64.1 inch long bed. Meanwhile, the body has been raised 2 inches to give the Tanok about 10 inches of ground clearance. With the tailgate down, VW says an ATV can fit in the Tanok's bed. For comparison, the Honda Ridgeline is 210 inches long, has a 64-inch bed, and offers slightly more than 7 inches of ground clearance. Under the hood, you'll find the same naturally aspirated 3.6-liter V6, 8-speed automatic, and all-wheel drive system that Volkswagen uses in the Atlas. Making 276 horsepower and 266 pounds-to-foot of torque, the Tanok's V6 is powerful enough at 60 miles per hour in 8.5 seconds, according to VW. That makes it significantly slower than the last Honda Ridgeline we tested, even though both trucks have similar power figures. Inside, there's seating for 5 in a surprisingly production-ready cabin. Designers tried to give the Tanok a look of its own by redesigning the center console, steering wheel, and instrument cluster. And while the Atlas offers plenty of buttons and knobs, the Tanok relies on a touchscreen for a cleaner, simpler look. The shifter and drive mode controller, on the other hand, still get physical controls that were reportedly designed to be used while wearing gloves. In New York, he said it is doable because it sits on the same MQB platform as the Atlas crossover and the new 5-passenger version of the Atlas. The pickup concept shows how far the MQB platform can be stretched, Wopkin said. And it helps the business case because of the economies of scale the platform offers. And while it is not at the top of his wish list, I didn't say it was off my list, he said. The automaker is likely testing the waters to see if the small truck market, which has recently grown with the return of the Ford Ranger, is ready for a VW-badged pickup. Unlike the foreign market Amarok, a production Tanok could be built and sold in the US relatively easily since the Atlas is already produced at VW's plant in Chattanooga, Tennessee.